two, three. First, let me just introduce my family. If you guys want to stand real quick, because this is not only my story, this is their story as well. My mother-in-law, my father-in-law, my wife, my daughter-in-law, and my grandchild, old Paisley. Thank you guys. Know me as John, but the rest of the world knows me as Big John the Dancing Trucker. I knew that was going to happen. My family and I have been attending Community Christian Church for a year now. We love Scott and his family, and I'm so grateful to share my story today. My story started in 2011 when I lost 100 pounds driving a truck and dancing. Before 2011, I always had an excuse for why I couldn't lose weight. I always told myself that I don't have the time to get fit while driving a truck, which is a good excuse at the time. With the death of my cousin and the death of a fellow truck driver from obesity, it really started making me think that I have to find a way to do something now and develop a no excuses attitude. So I joined Weight Watchers. My wife attends all the time, so I said, why not, let's join her. I started counting calories, thinking more about portion control and packing my lunches so I wouldn't starve or make poor choices throughout the day. A big role in my weight loss was Zumba, a dance fitness class I attended 3 times a week. For me, there's no better way to exercise than to tie my passion for dance and fitness together. In November of 2011, I became a Zumba instructor to help others. I taught Zumba classes for 4 months. Then I decided to branch out, create my own dance fitness moves, and dance music we all love that we hear every day on the radio. Big John's Dance Fitness was created in May of 2012. I taught 3 classes a week. I've even taught in my home and in my driveway. I have a passion and calling on my life to dance and to help others. Fast forward to March of 2015. I was on a dancing weight loss truck stop tour, that's right. Dancing at truck stop. Only I would do that. But that just shows you how passionate I am, right? So I'm not lying. I was 9 stops into the tour when on Sunday, April 26, 2015, I received a haunting phone call from my sister that my mother was in a car wreck. I jumped in the car and I drove to Lexington, Kentucky, where she had been airlifted. I walked into the emergency room and was greeted by her sister, who told me that my mother was killed by a drunk driver on her way to church. He was going 100 miles per hour in a 35 mile an hour zone. My mother was a good, loving Christian woman and raised me in church that way. I went to church 4 times a week growing up, which is a lot. Two times on Sunday, once on Thursday, but anyway. Even though I was devastated and felt like my world was coming to an end, that's when my faith in God kicked in and I knew she was in a better place. I just knew it instantly. 2 months later, after that, my family and I woke up at 2:30 in the morning to a house full of black smoke. The first floor of the house was fully engulfed in flames, and somehow with not being able to breathe and not being able to see the hand in front of my face, all 4 of us, me, my wife, my 2 boys, managed to escape from the 2nd floor. We had to start over again from scratch for the 2nd time in 90 days. Again, my faith kicked in. I leaned on God, I trusted in Him that things can only get better from here. I continued to dance that summer, going to Baltimore, Maryland and Dallas, Texas with great opportunities to keep my mind off the pure hell I've been going through. And today, my passion in dance and my faith in God is stronger than ever. My very first grandchild, Will Paisley, was born March 13, 2017. sent from heaven above. Thank you, Mom. Now I'm fully convinced that love is alive. Hope is alive. And dreams really do come true. Hit it.
Church in the world that has Big John the Dancing Trucker and DJ EZ for Easter. I'm just saying, that's how it's going to be. You know, John and his family lived two houses down from me, and I remember the night their house burned down, and you know, we were woken up by several fire trucks and police vehicles with their lights flashing out in front of our house, and our bedroom looked like a disco, honestly, at that time. And we go running outside to see what's going on, along with all the other neighbors, and just devastation. You know, after already knowing what John and his family had been through just months before that, it was amazing to see how John and his family and their faith has really played a part in their story. Because it'd be pretty easy for most of you and most of us to go, you know what, my story's over. You know, my weight, whatever that may be, if that's a challenge, my mother, my house, and just to give up. You know, God's not there. God doesn't care. My story's over. But John's story isn't over. John's story, although it looked like it was over, there's something greater in the future that God has prepared him for. And because he keeps looking for that and seeking that, God keeps using him to make a difference. You know, the message of Easter is very similar to that.